Hey guys, thank you for coming back for a new video. Today I have my first empty video and I put them in this super drag bag. Honestly, when all these empty videos trend started, I didn't like them, but lately I'm enjoying them very much. I found myself watching them more and more, which is weird. But yeah, I decided it's time to do my own. I don't have so many, but it's like skincare, body care, hair styling, and I think I have two items of makeup also. So let's get started. I just go randomly because I'll try to avoid to make too much noise. The first product is actually not from the categories mentioned. It's a liquid soap and it's the Care X Complete Moisture Plus Hand Wash Kills 99.9% of the bacteria. Well, why I'm including it, it's because I don't use it only to wash my hands, but I use it for washing my brushes. I find that it's really, really good, and also this bacteria killing, I think it's a plus. So I like it. I repurchased it a couple of times already, and yeah, I think this is actually my second or third bottle, but I have a new one in my bathroom right now. Okay, next is the Dove Oxygen Moisture for fine flat hair souffle treatment. Deeply moisturizes without weighing the hair down. I finished this actually quite a while ago, and on the moment when I used it, it was exactly what my hair needed. It provided exactly the amount of moisture that I wanted. Basically, it was ideal. Now the situation changed, and you'll find out a little bit later in the video why. But I really, really like this one, and if my hair goes back to that state, I will probably rebuy it because it was a really good hair treatment, hair mask, whatever. I'm not using hair conditioner, I'm using only masks every time when I wash my hair, basically because I'm washing my hair two times per week, so conditioner wouldn't be enough. And yeah, I really like it, and if your hair has dry ends but not like really, really dry, and your scalp towards your scalp you are more greasy, I totally recommend this hair mask. The next thing, it's actually, I have two boxes of it. It's the Clairol, I don't know how to pronounce this, nice and easy, no ammonia something. Her color is the non-permanent one, and I bought a shade medium ash. Now with this I really, really, really have a problem, except that it was nothing but ashy. It was more like golden tones in it. It also dried out my hair so badly, like my hair was never so dried. And not even when I was using permanent hair dyes with ammonia and everything. So I really, really hate this product. Like, the color is off, it destroyed my hair. Now I need to go with intensive treatments every time I wash it and after washing and whatever. Probably I should just chop off a big part of it because of this, but I'm still trying to resuscitate it. And yeah, I hate it. Why I bought this one and not the L'Oreal casting one, which I was buying when I was younger, it was because I couldn't find the shade that I wanted in that one. So I saw this one that is not permanent, blah blah blah, and yeah, I regret buying it. I totally regret buying it. I don't recommend it. I won't purchase it again, and all the jazz. Okay, next thing, it's skincare, and it's Bioderma Sensibio, and yeah, I use Bioderma for years now, maybe 2 years actually, and I really like it for removing my makeup. How I do it, it's I remove my makeup with Bioderma, then I wash my face with a cleanser, and it doesn't break me out. I bought it I don't know how many times in the past, now I have a full bottle in my bathroom. So yeah, Bioderma rules. I don't think I will give up using it anytime soon. Actually, have a review on my blog about it, I think. Yeah, I'll link it down below for you. Next is an eye cream, and is the Nuxe contour des yeux, prodigieux, blah blah. It's basically anti-fatigue moisturizing eye cream, anti-aging, anti-puffiness. Okay, anti-aging, well, not that old, am I? But actually, this is my favorite eye cream. Like, I really, 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 really like it. And I would repurchase it in a heartbeat if it didn't cost £18. But I will repurchase it soon. Yeah. After filming this video, I need to go to buy some stuff, so I might come back with one of these. But, well, I really, really like it. I didn't find anything that equals with it. Now I'm using the Superdrug eye cream and it's okay, I like it. But this one was, I don't know how many times better. Like, it's just nothing compares to it for me. So, yeah, definitely I will buy this in the future. Yeah. Next is a shower gel, which if you actually look on the bottle, it has something in it. But for the love of God, I can't take it. So I just give up and start the new one. And it's the Right Guard Shower Plus Oils Shower Gel for Women. It's for dual skin with argan, marula and almond oil. And I like how it smells, even my boyfriend likes how it smells, so he started to use my shower gel. But why I bought it, it's because it says it's for dual skin, and for some reason lately my skin is quite dry on my body, even with body butters and everything. No idea why, but I really like the smell. It didn't dry out my skin even further. I don't know if it did much for the moisturizing part, but my skin looked more bright a little bit. So yeah, it took from the dullness. It does what it says, but I don't think I will repurchase it because I need something more hydrating. Skincare again, and it's the L'Oreal Skin Perfection Advanced Correcting Serum. It's holy grail by this time, I love it. I think, I don't know, I bought it 3-4 times, I have no idea. I don't have a review on it, but I talked about it on my skincare routine video, which I posted last week, and I will link in the down bar. Basically, it's the best serum that I used at a reasonable price. Yeah, at a reasonable price. It's very similar to the Lancôme Visionnaire serum. I mean, similar. They have that LR24 something molecule both. I think in this one is less concentrated, but there is still, and it's appropriate for young skin. Like, if you're in your 20s, yeah, it works. I really like it. It helped with my acne scarring, and it adds one more layer of moisture. Though I have oily skin, I like my skin to be moisturized because I realized that like that it produces less oil. So yeah, I repurchased already and probably repurchase it more times in the future. Okay, this product is actually not empty, but I totally don't like it. It's the L'Oreal Triple Active Anti-Shine Mattifying Hydrating Moisturizer with Perlightened Salicylicate Acid. Hydrates, refines, mattifies for combination to oily skin. Long lasting matte effect. Okay, this makes a great base for makeup. I mean, with this I didn't need to apply primer and my foundation was looking wonderful. But the texture is weird and it gave me breakouts in one day. So this product is pretty much a no for me. So yeah, no, not my favorite product at all. Ah, by the way, I used it 2-3 times and my skin was getting so bad that I just put it aside and now I'm putting it straightly into the trash bin. Next one is the Sebamed Clear Face Care Gel for acne-prone skin, free from oils and emulsifiers, active natural moisturizer, allantoin and pantenol relieve irritation. I bought 2 or 3 of these. I like that the ingredient list is pretty simple. What I don't like about it is that it's not enough for me in winter. It doesn't moisturize my skin enough in winter. So probably I will repurchase this, but in summertime, because in winter it does nothing. But in summertime it looks nice and it makes actually a pretty good base for makeup. So yeah, it's pretty good. And I think it's pretty cheap also. It's under the £10 mark, but I'm not really sure. But under, definitely under £10. And the last two things are makeup items. One of them is the Maybelline The Rocket Mascara, and this is the waterproof version. And it's completely dried out, or at least it should be. Well, yeah, mostly dried out and empty and whatever. I really enjoyed this mascara, but I don't think, and I repurchased it actually a couple of times, but I don't think I'll repurchase it in the future because I found other mascara that I like more. So probably no more The Rocket for me. And last item, it's not empty but it needs to go away, is the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer, and I'm in shade NW15. I have it for too long, it kind of looks gross, so I think it needs to go away. And I think it's thickened, I don't know, it just needs to go away. I really like this concealer and I will repurchase it. Probably I will also try the NC15 shade to see if it suits me better. This one was okay, but well, I will repurchase it either in this shade or in NC15, but yeah, I recommend this concealer. A more affordable choice, and actually it's quite a dupe for it, which I'm using now, is the NYX HD Photogenic Concealer. And well, NYX products are cruelty free, cool. Yeah, it's good, but this is my holy grail. I want it back in my life. This was all my trash, so yeah, I hope you enjoy seeing what I used up. And I used up, I think, more products, but my boyfriend was throwing away when he was seeing empty stuff. So now these ones I managed to collect because I was putting in a bag and hiding them from him. But yeah, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and let me know if you want more empty videos. And see you next time. Give a thumbs up and subscribe. Bye bye.